An aspect ratio isn't just the relationship between a screen's width and height. It's also a storytelling tool. The decision to choose one ratio over another can shape how the audience perceives space, intimacy, and emotions. So today we're looking at a few aspect ratios and how to achieve that inside of Premiere. 16:9, also known as 1:7:8:1, is the standard for most content today, including this video, because most screens that we use today are that ratio, which makes this a full screen image without any aspect ratio bars. 4:3, or 1:3:3:1, is a nearly square format that dominated Hollywood from the 30s to the 50s. Those films weren't exactly 1:3:3:1, but in that world, and because it's more square, it does focus attention on the characters instead of landscapes. 1:8:5:1 came about in the early 50s as a way for Hollywood to separate the cinematic experience from the growing popularity of television, which had the boxier 4:3. 1:8:5 gives more room for environments while keeping nice height, giving an overall balanced middle ground before going to more anamorphic ratios like 2:3:9. Around the same time, anamorphic lenses were popularized by 20th Century Fox for the same reason. At first, we had the 2:5:5 aspect ratio, then 2:3:5, and then finally the modern 2:3:9, and what most would consider that classic cinematic look. There's way more to the history of that, including CinemaScope, but we're not going to get into all of that today. These anamorphic aspect ratios, like 2:5:5 to 2:3:5, give you a wide composition, lending itself well to epic landscapes, with films like Ben-Hur and Lawrence of Arabia using that to amazing effect. Finally, we have the 2:1 aspect ratio, which strikes a balance between 16:9 and 2:3:9:1. This creates an image that is wide enough to feel cinematic, but tall enough to live on modern TVs without heavy black bars. Shows like Stranger Things, The Crown, and Chernobyl all use this aspect ratio. But now that we've covered a handful of aspect ratios, let's jump into Premiere and look at a few ways that you can add these to your project. The first way we can accomplish this is by placing an adjustment layer at the top of your timeline. Then head to the effects controls, and we're going to leverage this crop section to bring in our bars. Doing it this way gives you the freedom to reposition your clip to fit whatever aspect ratio you want, and allows you to turn that layer off and still have your 16:9 export if needed. For specific numbers, if you are working with 16:9 footage and you want a 4:3 aspect ratio, you're going to crop the left and right by 12.5%. For 1:8:5:1, we're going to crop the top and bottom by about 2%. Technically, it's 1.95%, but I just do 2. For 2:3:9:1, crop both the top and bottom by 12.8%, or if you want to go further, do 13% for 2:4:0:1. And for the 2:1 aspect ratio, we're going to crop both by 5.5%. Again, the benefit of this is that it's non-destructive and gives you the ability to easily jump back to that 16:9 ratio. The downside is you are still exporting a 16:9 image, so if you want that wide aspect ratio, any wide monitor is still going to play it as a 16:9 image and not give you that full landscape, but there is a fix. Shifting your sequence settings will adjust the aspect ratio as a whole. All you have to do is go up to Sequence, Sequence Settings, and adjust the frame size. To find out the exact ratio, you could do some Googling or some mathing to figure out these formulas, but to calculate a video's dimensions for any aspect ratio, use width divided by aspect ratio to get the height, or height times aspect ratio for the width. So you can adjust either dimension while keeping the other fixed. But we're filmmakers, not mathematicians, so up on the screen now is a cheat sheet for both 1080 and 4K sequence dimensions that you may want to use. This covers the aspect ratios we talked about, so just plug that into your sequence settings and you're good to go. But there's also a best of both worlds approach. I'll edit in a 16:9 sequence using the adjustment layer with the crop settings to get my 2:3:9 bars. Then when I'm done with my edit, I'll create a new sequence with the dimensions of 3840 by 1608 and drag my 16:9 sequence into this new one. So I still have my 16:9 sequence to go back to if I need, while also having a proper 2:3:9 output. You could also use some sort of PNG that you can drop over your footage, but there is the risk that you could have a resolution mismatch, and this could lead to some soft or blurry edges on your black bars or visible pixelation. So I find it safest to either use an adjustment layer or change your sequence settings. And of course, this is all talking about faking those ratios, not having the true ratio from an open gate or anamorphic footage. And that's it for today, but I am curious, what's your favorite aspect ratio to shoot in? Put that in the comments below, and while you're down there, let us know if there's something you'd like to see us cover in the future. And don't forget to like and subscribe, because I love you. Now say it back.